The next question, Brother, is asking how to give a dawah to a non-Muslim. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. In order to give a dawah, any Muslim can do that. According to the hadith of the Prophet the Prophet said, "Balighu anni wal aya." Now, that means like even the one verse you know of the Holy Quran, you need to propagate that properly. And also, there's a formula given in the Surah An-Nahl. Verse number 125, where it's Allah says, "Udu ila sabili Rabbika bil hikmati wal mu'izatil hasana wa jadilhum billati hi ahsan." And there's another verse in the Surah Fussilat, verse number 33, where Allah says, "Wa man ahsanu qala mimman da'a ila Allahi wa 'amila salihan wa qala innani minal muslimin." So basically, the first verse that I quoted from the Surah Nahl, verse number 125, that has a very beautiful formula on how to give a dawah. Number one, you have to have a little knowledge. Number two, you have to have a patience. And you have to spend more time in listening to other person that he has something inside him. He wants to say it about this line, what misconceptions that you have. And then allow him a time to talk. And then you can start talking. And then you try to explain him something from the very basic. In order to give a dawah, you do not have to have a PhD degree. You do not have to be a big scholar. You do not have to be something a Maulana or the big Imam or nothing. You can be just a general Muslim who knows about Islam, who knows Allah is one and the Creator is one and the last messenger. You know this thing and that's it. That's what you have to call to a non-Muslim. Explain him that all the universe and everything is created by one God, and then explain him how Adam was being created, and how Allah has asked the angels to prostrate Adam, and how one of them whose name was being mentioned in the Bible was a Lucifer, but in Quran it is being mentioned as an Iblis, who was among the jinns, and he is the one who was being arrogant, and he rejected the to obey Allah, and he did not follow the commandments of Allah, but rather he knew it, but he rejected the commandment of Allah. So he was rejected. So he asked Allah to allow him a permission for the list of things that he asked Allah to give me a permission. I'm going to do that. Now the first thing that Iblis, the Lucifer who asked Allah, was the first thing was, give me a free will. And the number two was that what he do with the free will, he will misguide the human beings. And what is the first misguidance of the human beings by Lucifer the Iblis? The first misguidance was he will attack the human beings by whispering in their hearts or by from external power. And how would he's being convincing and deceiving a human being by inside the heart, by it's called a devil whisper. He will basically put their faith, the human being's faith, their beliefs on other objects. That's why when a person becomes a Muslim, that's what he testifies. I testify there is no deity worthy of worship. Either it's an object, it's an idol, it's a Jesus, peace be upon him, or it's a Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or anyone, even the messenger of Allah, or anyone is nothing except the one power of Allah. He has to testify that I believe there is one creator. And I believe everything is created by one God, and he is supposed to be worshipped and nothing else to be worshipped. And then he has to believe that the messengers came from all the way from Adam alayhi salam, then there was a Noah alayhi salam, and the Sheet alayhi salam, and there's Abraham alayhi salam, and Abraham has two wives, Hajar alayhi salam, and there was a Sarah. Hajar was on the Arab side, Sarah was on the Jewish side. On the Hajar lineage, there was Ishmael alayhi salam was born from Hajar, and Isaac was born from the Sarah, and the more of the messengers came from the Sarah side, than the Hajar al-Islam. It was the reason because the Jewish were the most corrupted people. But if you look at the genealogy of the both trees, so everybody will understand that on the Arab, after Ishmael al-Islam, no messenger of God came. And it was after so many generations, the last messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was came after Ishmael. But on the Sarah side, they bore a son, Isaac alaihissalam, and Isaac has a son of Jacob, where in the Quran he's being mentioned as a Yaqub alaihissalam, and he has a 12 sons, and among them there was a one son was being selected as a messenger of God. He was a Joseph, and from the 12 sons there was a one son whose name was Yehuda, and from the lineage of the Yehuda, if you go all the way downside, the Moses alaihissalam was being born on that lineage, and if you go more down, the Maryam alaihissalam, Mary, peace be upon him, was born, and from Mary, Jesus, peace be upon him, was born. And after Jesus, 600 years later, on the Arab side, the last messenger was born was on the Arab side, after the 600 years after the Jesus, peace be upon him. So we can have a little knowledge, and we try to explain everything from the basic. How does the whole problem started? The whole problem was started when God created Adam alayhi salam, and God asked all the angels to prostrate Adam alayhi salam, including the Lucifer, Iblis, and all of them prostrated, obeyed, went to the sajda and accept Iblis, who knew it that God has commanded him, but rather he knew it, but still he said, I would not listen to you. That's it. I'm sorry, I rejected. So because of that, God rejected him. And because God rejected him, he got more arrogant, and he got more ego. Then he said to the God to allow me free will, and do not interfere in my work. So the God said, okay, I allowed you to do that. I allowed you to do that. I allowed you to do that. And then the Lucifer, he asked the free will. Then he asked, the first thing I will misguide the human beings by whispering in their heart and putting their faith, putting their belief onto something else. Like for example, in Asian countries, they worship the idols. In the South Asian countries, like in India, they worship idols. And also in the Buddhism, they worship Buddha, and but many people have their own faith. Like in India, they have a 33 crore Bhagwans, and they call it a god. And many people, they worship graves. Like in Pakistan, people worship graves, they go to the auliyas, and these are all shirk. And this is what it means: do not associate partners with Allah. That means Allah is alone, he is alone power, he is alone doer for everything. And this is basically we have to explain to non-Muslims how to give a dawah to them, explain them about how was everything created, how was Adam was created, and how's the Quran. Then you come to the Quran is the word of God, and how Bible is not the word of God, because the Bible was being the language of Bible was an Aramaic. How the original scripture, the original revelation that came to the Jesus, peace be upon him, his language was Aramaic. So this is very logical answer. This is a very logical thing to understand. If his language was Aramaic, then definitely the revelation of God was in Aramaic. So what happens by the time moved on, people corrupted the original scripture, and the first translation from the Aramaic language, that was into the Latin Greek language. And then from the Latin, from the Greek language, the first translation was in, and then it was English from the Greek. So it was from English from the Greek, and the Greek from the Aramaic. So the Greek and everything was being disappeared, and by the time it has an English translation, if you look at today, there's so many translations, the original Aramaic does not exist yet. So this is very simple to explain to a non-Muslim, a Christian. It's very simple to explain them that the Bible is not even the word of the The name of the book. Basically, Bible means like the library of books which have been compiled long time ago. And the Bible that has a red lettering, it is considered as a, is the word of the Jesus, peace be upon him, which is not true either. So many things by the time it's being moved. But if anybody would go back and try to find the original scripture of Aramaic, it doesn't exist. So they have to go back to the original scripture, which was being Quran, which is never being changed things more than 1400 years. So we can explain like many, many things. So until they understand logically and they can understand by scientifically and understand by the Quran is the word of God and the Bible is not the word of God, and how Lucifer, for the Iblis, is being playing with the human beings to remove their faith from worshiping one God, and they're putting their faith into something else, like on an idol. It could be a dead body, it could be a grave, it could be a shrine, it could be anything. That's what it says. When a non-Muslim convert to Muslim, he testified that I believe there is no God but Allah, there is no deity worthy of worship, even object, even an idol, even it's a stone or whatever. This is what they testify. So there's many things to give a dawah. And the best formula you have to follow is you have to have a patience, you have to know a little bit things about Islam. Just you're good to go, because you don't need to be a big scholar, you don't need to like PhD degree. All you have to do is very simple, just try to be make it very basic as possible, not go beyond the basic things, because the things get more complicated into more deep things. So rather we stick to the main point, which is worship the one creator and do not worship anything else except the creator who created you, who created you, me, who created everything. He's the alone creator of everything.